mentioned as well, Karch Karai. You can see the emotions on his sleeve. Different energy tonight, but I can't wait to hear what you'll say.
Well, I think I told you before each of these matches, this is what we expect. This is one of the great teams and great programs in the world. Jenny does a fantastic job with them. They've got a lot of really good young players who are going to get better and improve tremendously over the next few years. And so this is what you'd expect, that they would bounce back and come at us hard. They really turned the tables on us with their serving. Our serving was really successful last night. Theirs was tonight. And so, of course, that changed the passing equation and changed our ability to run the offense that we wanted to run. So they stressed us in lots of ways. And that's awesome. That's why we play these matches and why we bring these really good teams in to learn, to be put in positions of adversity and discomfort, and then to learn from it. And so we had a lineup out there that is capable of playing really well and playing with that team, but we just made too many errors, I think, in this first game alone, 8 or 9 unforced errors, and you can't expect to win a game giving the other team 8 or 9 free gifts like that. So hats off to China. I love that they came back at us hard. A much better and stronger and more sustained response than the one that they came back or came at us with in set 3 last night when they came at us. So this is awesome. We'll fly back to the mainland tomorrow. We'll make some adjustments and we'll get to get after it again in round 3 with each team having won a match. We'll play on a Tuesday night at UC Irvine and then a fourth one coming up. This coming Friday, the fourth and final match in San Bernardino. So I'm glad that we're getting pushed like this. It's no fun to lose. It's probably the most disappointing thing is we didn't really come at them and have a strong response in set number 3. That's not usual for us. We want to come back and go down fighting, and we didn't do enough of that. So that's probably my biggest disappointment for this evening's match. But this is a long, long process, and you're going to have disappointments and some pain and some suffering, and that's part of getting to be the team that we want to be, that we need to be, that we aspire to be. So thank you.
Maybe one more question for Karch before he heads off. Maybe more than one more question. Anyone? Yes, Jay.
It's often said that there's more to lose from more to gain from hard loss and a good win. Enjoyable. It's apparent that you went with the lineup tonight and it didn't go so well at all. And you planned to stick with it and you did it. And I think that's wonderful. The girls do their thing. They didn't turn around the last game, but they're going to learn a lot from them. And I think it's incredible kind of family that's been built, and the integrity and respect for one another, and really cool. Fun to see.
Well, thank you, Jay. Just because we win a match doesn't mean we were good necessarily. So a win does not mean that we were doing the things that we want to do. And a loss doesn't necessarily mean we weren't doing the things, although tonight it did mean that there were some things we were lacking in for sure. And it definitely, those losses can point those out more clearly for players especially. But we have some work to do to get back to our normal level of aggressiveness at the service line and to handle the serving of China. They came at us with some heat. Number 9 was just sending rockets across the net. Not jump spin rockets, but jump float rockets. And so that was really good practice for our passers. It's going to make us better in the long run. We love it when our servers in our own gym come really hard at our passers. It's one of the things that we tell our team. The best way to honor your teammate, your great friend across the net, this is not something that's necessarily as easy for women generally as it is for men, but the best way to honor your teammate and your great friend across the net is to go at her with everything you have. And so when our servers do it in our gym, it makes us better, and China made us better tonight even though we're suffering for it right now. But in the long run, it's going to make us better for sure.
Tony Crabb, you want to end us up with one more question?
My own. Put me on the spot.
Tony Crabb, just give him some time to think about it. Karch is coach, gold medal team, Team USA back in the 80s, one of the innovators.
How important is it for you now to have a starting team that plays a lot?
It is not important in this series, just as it was not important a year ago. We played four different starting lineups against Brazil in four matches against Brazil. And I expect we'll do the same. The object is to be able to put different people on the court, much like we do in practice. We rarely have people playing together for very long. We switch them up a lot. We want them all used to playing with each with different partners, with different teammates. Get used to elevating the play of those around you, no matter which five or six people are around you. And we're going to continue to do that for the rest of this series. So the objective is we believe we can put out lots of lineups that can have success against some of the great teams in the world. We did against Brazil last year, and our objective is to bounce back strong against China on Tuesday, and it'll be a different lineup than it was tonight.
When in your calendar will your starting team start to play a lot?
If you watched us during the World Championships, we did not have necessarily a starting team that we used consistently in that tournament. There were two reasons for that. Number one, we have a couple of really good middle hitters, Krista Harmato-Dietzen and Feluka Akinrawa. You saw Feluka play last night. Krista is on the mainland, a caged tiger ready to go on Tuesday. So we'll unleash her versus China probably in that match. But they have they've had a number of physical challenges the last couple of years. So any tournament we play from this point forward, we do not plan on them playing each and every match in that. We want to be four deep or three deep in the middle to be able to play with any pair of middles on the court. And if you watch World Championships, we only had those two on the floor together three or four times out of 13 matches, or maybe five times out of 13 matches. So we needed to conserve them. That 13 matches in 20 days is a long time. And so we want to be deep, and we want to be fresh at the end. And we were able to do that in World Championships by not playing a consistent starting lineup. Krista went several matches without playing. Feluka tweaked something and went several matches without playing. Jordan, same thing. So one of the beautiful things about this tour is that we get some younger players, some other players, that opportunity, and it helps us identify which four middle blockers we will take to the World Cup in August. We have 11 matches in 15 days. There's no way we're playing Feluka and Krista all 11 of those matches. We have to be able to rest and use lots of different people, and this is one of the best opportunities for us to identify who those people will be and to start getting into the habit. Maybe once we get to the Olympics, where you get a day, if we qualify, where you get a day of rest between every match, we can think about a more consistent lineup. But it's not going to be able to be that way in this gnarly 11 matches in 15 days. We're going to play lots of different people. Good question.
How about a big round of applause, Karch Garai, greatest player of all time on the quest to gold.